yes now okay right yes today we are going to discuss a very important topic of optimization that is the project scheduling. Why I am telling the project scheduling is very important because already previous year there was two question from project scheduling, and as per the NTA pattern I have seen, as per the NTA pattern, project scheduling is common part of the software engineering and in the optimization also, and they are nowadays they are focusing on the flow chart. And from the flow chart already there was the question, five question was there, that is from complexity graph. So that's why it is my assumption that it may be not true, but I think that from the project scheduling they can ask the question. So please watch this video till the end, and it will be helpful before your exam. Okay. And one thing, yes, so project scheduling, that is the project management. Okay. Project scheduling technique is the CPM, critical path method. It is there in the syllabus already. So critical path method means you can think that is a software engineer. When the software engineer scheduling the project, we are going to schedule the project, then we have to define that when is the starting and when it is the ending, and we are dividing total project in some module, right? In the software engineering we have already learned that we are dividing the project in module and we are distributing the work to different team. There are different team. Now there is the problem that if there is dependency, if the module is independent, then there is no problem. But if the modules are dependent, if there is the dependency between one module to another module, then there is the problem. Then you have to go for the project scheduling, because maybe that is I am doing the login module and you are doing the payment module, right? Or I am doing the registration module or you are doing the payment module. So before confirming the before completion of register module, we cannot start the payment module. So maybe the registration module take 5 days. So these 5 days you have to wait before completion of payment module. You can do your testing, you can do your research about payment module, what how to do and anything, but you cannot complete your payment module because it is dependent. Because after registration only you have to start the payment module, right? So that's why now we are going for the CPM and part, that is the what is project management. A project consists of interrelated activities which are to be executed in a certain order, right? Because it is interrelated, and activities are interrelated and logical sequence which is known as the precedence of relationship. What are the precedents? There are different types of precedent, and project is represented by the form of network. Here we will represent the project in a form of network. So see, that is the technique. What is the technique? CPM, critical path method. So in the project management, a project so here that is the construction of network. How to do the construction? Hi Tamil, good morning. Construction, that is scheduling, determine the start and end time of each and every activity. First you have to determine what is the start and what is the end. Now you have to control. How to control? That is use the array in the diagram, in the time chart, and continuous monitoring of the progress reporting. Means we are using the arrow, and using the arrow we are trying to monitor that when it is start, when it is end. Now there is the most important thing of the guideline. What are the guideline? That is starting event and ending event should be unique. Starting event and ending event should be unique always. So, and this is may most important, that starting event is always called the tail event. Remember that starting event, maybe you are getting confused that starting means it is head. No, starting means it is tail. Because when you are ending your task, that is the head. That is the head. When you are starting, that is the tail. Okay, remember that starting means it is tail and ending means it is head. Okay. and no activity should be presented by more than one or network. Okay, and two, no two activities same starting, same ending, you cannot be. And dummy activity, you have to imagine the dummy activity when there are some problem. How? See, here this is the schedule, and don't be confused with the schedule. Don't think it is a big example how we will do in the exam. First of all, I want to say that because I am taking a big example. You all know that always I am taking the big example so that your concept should be clear and any question you can do. And I have already seen that last year from the cyclomatic complexity, there was 5 question from one one chart was there. From that one chart there was 5 question, means 5 into 2, that is 10 marks was there from one question. So maybe they can give this type of question also. From this question they can, different types of question they can ask, that are the comprehension type question they can ask from here. That's why I am telling that this is very important. Okay, so see, there are the activity. What are the activity? Here it is activity A, right? And here the immediate predecessor. What are the immediate predecessor? It is mentioned here. See, there is no predecessor, means it is an independent activity. When there is the gap, means this is the independent activity. Now next one, that is the duration. Duration, maybe you can think here it is in month, means 2 months. Duration of the activity A, that is 2 months. Now next, that is B, that is 5 months. C, that is 4 months. And all A, B, C are independent. There is no predecessor. Now for the D, there is B. And it is starting duration 5. So in that way, everything will be given to you. Either they can provide you this table or they can write down in statement. So from the statement, you have to draw the table. Anyway, they can give you, right? So here you can see that is the E. For the E, predecessor is A. For the D, predecessor is B. What is the meaning? That is the meaning that before completion of B, D cannot be start. Means D is dependent on B. Before completion of B, D cannot be start. Okay. So from here, you have to draw the chart. How to draw the chart? I am showing you that how to draw the chart, right? So is it clear that what is project scheduling and how, why we are doing the project scheduling? Why we are doing the project scheduling? I am taking a new sheet for describing everything. How to draw the chart? It is very interesting and it is very easy. See, here first you have to check what are the independent activity A, B, C. A, B, C are independent, right? So we can start from the, this is our starting, means we are taking that this is the one, this is the starting. Okay, from here A, B, C is independent. So I am starting from here, that is A. I am starting from here, that is B, and here that is C. Okay, now here A is taking how much time? 2. So write down here 2. B is taking how much time? That is 5. Write down here 5. C is taking how much time? That is 4. Write down here 4. Okay. Now see that after that D. After the D, come to D. And the immediate predecessor of D is B. Means after B only D can start. Right. So here B is completion. Here B is completing the tasks, here A is completing the tasks, here C is completing the tasks. So write down the name of ending, that is 2, 3 and 4. 2, 3, 4. Yes, good morning Ranju. Good morning Ranju. 2, 3, 4 already done. Now after that D is starting, that is D after B. So after B we are starting that D. Now before that you have to think that is there any other dependency with B? Is there any other dependency that after A and B that anything can come? See here, that is any other dependency using D. D के ऊपर dependency है, देखो C and D. Here C and D, it is dependent G, H. H will start after completion of C and D. Means you have to merge the C and D. Here H is starting and I is starting after C and D. So when you are drawing the chart, you have to see the everything where it is dependency. So you can see B, D is starting after B, but C and D, the H and I is dependent on C and D. Means you have to merge C and D. Means how we can run, that is C is completing here, so we can do that is D is coming here, right? Because we are merging C and D, because after merging another task is going to start. And how much time of D? D ka time kitna tha? How much? That is 5. So write down here 5. Okay. Now next one, that is E. E is starting after A and F is also starting after A. And check that ki E and F, is there any other dependency between E and F? See here for the F. Here it is F, here it is F, F, G and H. Everything is merging, after that K and L is coming. Right? F, G and H, everything is merging, after that K and L is coming. So there is the dependency in F. Right? So and E, after E, J is starting. Right? So I am drawing that E, how much time for the E? E was 7, so write down E and here 7, means here it was already 1, 2, 3 and 4, here write down that is 5, okay, and it is 7 already done. Now come to the F, now come to the next F, that is A, so F, I am drawing F and after D only, that is F is starting, so write down here F3. F was how much? F time was 3. Right. So F is done. Now next one, after F there is G. There is G and you can see F and G is merging. F and G is merging here. F and G is merging here. Means after merging only you can start. So here F, after F it is A. After F I am starting, F is already done and G. For the G, G is starting after B. So after B, I am starting the G and I am merging here because we already see that is F and G is merging. So G is 3 and I am doing it 6. Okay. Now next one. After G, is it got it? Got my point? If you are facing any issue then and there, tell me. Okay. Now H is starting after C and D and here F, G we already merge and H will merge with the G, right? So I am starting the H after C and D. So C and D is finished here. Here was C, here was D. C and D is finished here. So here already we have merged F and G. So we are merging H here also, because we need to merge H, so we are merging H here. So H is, that is 6. How much time for H? H is 6. Right? 6 likh do yahan pe. So now H is done. Now I is also starting after C and D. So check here for the I, is there any dependency? M is starting only I. So there is no dependency. So I can write down I. Self, I, there is no dependency, means it is, there is no merging karne ka koi zarurat nahi hai. So for the I, how much? That is 2. I is 2. So we are writing here 2, right? So I 2 ho gaye. Now after that I is done, J is starting after E. So where is E is done? Here E is done. So we can write down that is J, how much was J? J was, that is 5, right? Write down here 5. Okay. Repeat for H. H is starting after C and D. After merging, here we are merging C and D. C is merge here. C and D is merge in that point 4. C and D merge here in that point of 4. And after merging only, H is starting. Okay, Poonam. See that here H is starting C and D after merging. And I is also starting after merging of C and D. Means after completion of C and D, then only H and I is starting. That's why we are writing here H and I. Now for the H, there is another dependency that F, G and H all are merging here. F, G and H all are merging because after merging only K and L can start. That's why we have merged here F, G and H. That is in 6. Okay, Poonam. Now I is already done. Theek hai? So I done ho gaye. So C, D done. J now come to the point of J is E, JE 5 done. So I am writing that is the 8, number 8, right? It was 7. So it is 8, right? Now J after that K and L is starting after F, G and H. So K and L means, and here after C, K and L is after G and H. Now see that is there any merging of K and L. See here J and K is merging here. J and K is merging here means you have to merge J and K. Here we are finishing J. So you can write down there K. Try to write down K. K that is how much? K is 4. K is 4. And why we are merging? Because next you need to merge it because there is the dependency between J and K, right? So K was 4 done. Now after that L is starting after F, G, H, and there is no need to merge. So we are writing here L. L is 3, right? After that is M is starting after I and it is 12 and there is no dependency. So I am writing here M. M is starting. That is M. M is 12. Now after M there is N. N is starting after J and K. N. N is starting. N that is 8. 8. 8 is starting. Now after L, M, N, everything is done and there is end. Now the project is end. There is everything is end. Means this 3 line will be end here. This 3 line finally it is the ending of the project. We are ending the project. That is the 9. Got it? How the chart is coming? It is the 9. So finally it is coming here. Now just see this. Now let me clear it and just see this. It is already I have drawn here only. Just see this chart and try to understand the chart, how I have drawn and how to draw the chart. See this. Clear? Any doubt? Anyone have any doubt? Surbhi, Sujata, Sarita, Monali, and Ranju, Tamil, Poonam. Anyone have any doubt? If you have any doubt, you can ask, because we have to go for the next. Clear. Okay, very good. It is clear. So now I am coming here. Yes. Now what you have to do? Now here they will ask that the starting and ending time. Now you have to do the starting and ending time. Here for the starting, this from here we are starting. From here we are starting that you have to draw. This is the zero. This is the zero means here we have start, right? Now from the zero you have to check the next one. For the next one, how much time? That is 0 plus 2. There is 0 plus 2 means write down here 2. Next one, there is 0 plus 5. That is write down here 5. Now there is 0 plus 4. That is we are writing here. That is 4. Right? It is clear to everyone? No. It will be? No. Now here is the problem. Now here is the problem. That is it 4? Can we write here 4? Now here is the problem. Why we cannot write here 4? Can we? What will be the value for this? What will be the value for this part? Here what we have to write? Tell me. Because here there was only independent. Here only independent task, that is A. So we are writing here 2. Here only B. That's why we have write here 5. Now what we have to write here? How much time it is taking? Here you have to think about the maximum. You have to think about the maximum because we are merging here C and D. We are merging here C and D. So how much time it is taking to complete the C and D? You have to take the maximum. How to take? How to take? Yes, Subhangi, you are correct. How to take? That is, you see that for B means it is first B is starting, B is taking 5. After that D is starting, D is taking 5, that is 10. So for B plus D, it is taking 10. And C is taking only 4. C is taking only 4 and B is taking 10. Now Monali, why you are telling 14? Why you are telling 14, Monali? Try to understand. C and B is independent. So from here when you are starting, maybe Monali already start. Monali is doing his work, that is her task. So Monali, you are doing it for the 5 days, that is from today. Maybe you can think that is from today you have start, and Sarita also start from this today. Today only Sarita also start. So Sarita have done in 4 days and you have done is 5 days. Is there any dependency? So why we are adding? There is no need to add because there is no dependency. Ek hi saath, matlab ek hi din mein ek hi saath aap kaam kar rahe ho, right? There is no dependency. B is independent, C is independent. There is no dependency. So there is no need to add. At the same time, parallelly you are doing the task. B and C are the parallel task and the starting time was same. So B is completed within 5 days and C is completed within 4 days. So parallelly, the task is going parallelly. So no need to add. Only D, for the D there is dependency because after B only D is started. Right? That's why from here B plus D it is 10 and C it is 4. So what is the maximum? You have to take the maximum, that is 10. Means you have to write down here 10. Got it? Is it clear now? 10. Now tell me, what is the value of this? What will be this? For this one? For this one? Yes. For this one you have to take, that is 2. It was end in 2. After that E is starting, that is 2 plus 7. Here you have to do 2 plus 7, that is 9. Now for the next. For the next, that is J. J is starting after the after A, E. So 9 plus 5 you have to do, that is it is 14. It is 14, right? And here also it is starting after I. After I, that is 10 plus 2, that is 12. 10 plus 2, that is 12, right? Now next one. See, come to here. Tell me which is the value for this one. Tell me the value for 6. For this one, 6. What is the value? What will be the value for 6? 6, how much? 6. What is the value for 6? What is the value for 6? Try, everyone, try and tell me. What is the value for 6? Answer, everyone, answer. Try to do with me, then only your concept will be clear. Your concept will be clear. Try to do with me. Everyone, 12 live learners I can see. Please try to understand and try to do. First thing that for 6, how much merging? We are merging here, that is F, G and H. F, G and H is merging here. Right? Yes. For F, G and H. So, how much we are merging here after A? F is starting, that is A plus F, how much? That is 2 plus 3, that is 5. Now for B and G, B then G. So B plus G, B is taking 5 and G is taking 3, that is 8. Now for another one, that is what we are doing, ki after B here see this part, that is after B, D is starting, then H is starting. Here we have already told that is 10, this 4 is already 10. After this H is starting means 10, means from here we have already done 10. After that H is starting, that is 6, that is 16. So what is the maximum? Here it is 5, here it is 8 and here it is 16. So, what is the maximum? 16 is the maximum, means you have to do here 16. Got it? Monali correct, Sarita correct, Rahul also correct. Monali, Sarita, Rahul, Poonam also correct. Sinu, Subhangi, Sinu and Subhangi, is it clear now how the 16 is coming? Yes, all possible path you have to consider, because you are merging here. We are merging the task, means you have to think about all the path, right? All possible path you have to consider, right? So here it is 16 done. Now only remaining is that is now here I have done one mistake. Here it will be no 14. Here it is not 14. What is the value of this area? What will be for 8? 8 is merging here, H and K. H and K is merging here in the 8. So, what will be the value for 8? 8 here, that is 9 plus 5. Here it is 9 plus 5, that is 14. And here it is 16 plus 4. 16 plus 4, that is 20. So, what is the maximum? Maximum is 20. 8, for the 8, it will be the 20, right? Now, what will be the value for this? That is 9. For the 9, what will be the value for 9? For the 9, last one, what will be the value for 9? For the last one, what will be the value? That is ending. When the project is ending, final end, what will be the value? End, 9. Yes, for the 9, what is there? That is 20. Plus 8, that is 28, and for this one, that is 16 plus 3, that is 19, and for this one, that is 12 plus 12, that is 24. So which one is maximum? 24, 19 and 28. Which one is maximum? 28 is maximum, right? 28 bits maximum. Now it is the forward path, it is the forward tracking, the forward track is done, forward track is done. Now you have to do backward, now you have to go backward. Why? Because you have done the, what is the ending time, what is the ending time, it is done. Now you have to go for the starting time. What is the starting time? You have to go backward. Now you have to do the backtrack. For understanding the critical path, you have to determine the critical path by backtracking. By backtracking again, you have to do, that is the, what is that backtrack? Backtrack means here it is already done 28, means write down here 28. Write down here 28. Now for this one, what will be the value for this one? What will be the value for this one? Do the backtracking. That is the means why we are writing, that is box. Box is the estimated starting. ES. That is the ES. ES is what? That is ES full form. That is the starting, earlier start. ES means that is the earlier start, earlier start, earlier start. And LS, you have to do now LC. LC is the latest completion time, latest completion time. Okay, LC is the latest completion time. So what is the latest completion time? How to do? That is LC should be, here it was 28 and here now you have to do the minus. You have to do the minus here, from here. From here we are going here. So it is 28 minus 8, that is 20. 28 minus 8, that is 20. Right? Now for this one. For this one, what will be the value? Here it was 28 and here it was 12. So 28 minus 12. 28 is here, 12 is here. How much time it is taking? 12. So what is that? That is the 16. 16, right? Now for this one, what will be the value? What will be the value for 6? 6 ke liye kitna hoga batao? What will be the value for 6? Why? Because you have to do the critical path. From this one, they are asking that what is the critical path, or they can ask what is the earliest starting time, what is the latest completion time. ES means earliest starting time. The box. Box is the ES, and triangle we are doing the LC. LC is the latest completion time and ES is the earliest start time. Okay. Completion time means what? You have done here 28. Now duration, how much duration for this work? Duration is 8. So 28 minus 8, that is 20. Okay. And for here, you have to think, here it is merging. Here it is merging, and how much dependency? 25. Is it 25? Here it was 20, here it was 28. So 28 minus 3 is 25, here 20 minus 4 is 16, here 20 minus 4, you have to take here minimum. When you are doing the backward, then you have to check all the possible path and you have to take the minimum. For the forward part, you have to take the maximum, and for the backward part, you have to take the minimum. Because why we are taking the minimum? That is that is the latest completion time. Latest completion time. That what is the latest? Means last. What is the latest completion time? When you have completed your task. During backtracking, you have to take the minimum value. And during forward, you have to take the maximum value. Now, you have to check all the possible path. Here it is 20. Here it is 28. 20 minus 4 you have to do, that is 20 minus 4, that is 16. And here it is 28 minus 3, that is 25. So which one you have to take? That is 16. You have to take here 16. Clear? Is it clear? Okay, got it. 16. Okay, now tell me, what will be the value for this? What will be the value for 5? What will be the value for 5? What will be the value for 5? Do with me. What will be the value for 5? When you are doing the backtracking, just try to check the outgoing arrow. Try to check the outgoing arrow, and when you are forward tracking, try to do check the incoming arrow. That is the best trick. Forward pass, that is try to check the incoming arrow, and for the backward pass, try to check the outgoing arrow. Yes, only outgoing arrow is this. Only this is the outgoing arrow, that is 20 minus 5, that will be 15. 15. And now for this one. For this one, what will be the value? 2. How much value for 2? For 2, what will be the value for 2? From 2, what are the outgoing? Outgoing is E and F. 2. What are the outgoing? Check the outgoing arrow. Check all the outgoing arrow. What are the outgoing arrow? E, F are the outgoing arrow. Here it was 15. Here what are 16? So 15 minus 7 and 16 minus 3. Which one is minimum? 15 minus 7 and 16 minus 3. Which one is minimum? That is 8. 15 minus 7 is minimum. That is 8. 8. Good. Now for 3. What is the value for 3? What is the value for 3? For 3, what are the outgoing? What are the outgoing? Outgoing kon hai? And before coming to 3, you have to do the 4. Before coming to 3, you have to do the 4. Because without 4, you cannot do 3. So, before coming to 3, you have to go to the 4. Because it is outgoing to 4. So, you have to do the 4. So, first do the 4. For the 4, what will be the value? 4 outgoing arrow is this, H and I. H and I is outgoing. For the H, it was 12, 16 minus 6, that is 10. And here it is 16 minus 2, that is 14. 16 minus 6, that is 10. And here it is 16 minus 2, that is 2. So, for the 4, what will be the value? 16 minus 6, that is 10. 10 will be the value. Why 14? Minimum, you have to take the minimum. Here it was 16 and here it was 6. 16 minus 6, that is 10. And here it is 16 minus 2, that is 14. So, you have to take 10. Minimum you have to take, right? Now, next one. Now, for this 3, what is the outgoing from the 3? That is G and D. So, G was 16 and here it was 10. So, 16 minus 3, that is 13, and here it is 10 minus 5, that is 5. So, what will be the value for 3? Here it was 16 minus 3, 16 minus 3, that is 13. And here it is 10 minus 5, that is 5. 5, right? So, minimum is 5. Minimum is 5, right? Now, come here. Now, come to the starting point. For the starting point, what are the outgoing arrow? A, B and C. For the A, it was 8. For the B, it was 5. And for the C, it was 10. So, 8 minus 2, that is 6. 5 minus 5, that is 0. 10 minus 4, that is 6. So, which one is minimum? Minimum is 0. That is 5 minus 5, 0. Got it? 5 minus 5, that is 0. Is it clear? Is it clear what we are doing? Yes, now the forward pass and backward pass is done, and estimated earliest start and latest completion is done. Earliest start and latest completion is also done. Now you have to check that from which node earliest start and latest completion is same. Means you have to check where that is square and the triangle value are equals. That is earliest start and the latest completion is equal. From where it is equal? Here it was equal 0 0, and where it is equal? That is 5 and 5. Here it is equal. Where another one is equal? That is 10 and 10. Here it is equal. And where it is equal? That is 16 and 16. It was equal. And anywhere that is the 28 and 28, it is equal, right? So now from this you can draw the critical path. What of the critical path? So from 0 it is going to B, that is the critical path. After that it is coming to C, it is coming to 4, it is the critical path. After that it is going to this way, that is 6, it is the critical path. After that, finally, from here, it is coming to this way, that is the critical path. Not this way. One thing I have missed. Not this way, here. Here, there was 20 into 20. So, after 16, it is coming to here. And finally, it is coming to here, right? So, 0. Now, if you calculate, join means how I register, ma'am, please share the details. Register, where you want to register? Thimmappa. Where you want to register? I would like to join paper. I am not getting you. Where you want to register? Where you want to register? I am not getting you. See, so how the critical path? So here you can see, that is what is the timing? What is this timing? 0 plus 5, 5. 5 plus 5, that is 10. 10 plus 6, that is 16, 16 plus 4, that is 20, 20 plus 8, that is 28. How the critical path is coming? That is, you have to check the value for the square and triangle. Value for the square and triangle, what it is equal, where it is equal. Value for the triangle and square, where it is equal. Equal is here, 0, 0. Equal is here, 5, 5. 10, 10, 16, 16, 20, 20, 20, 20, 28, 28. So, finally, you can add, that is, it was 0. 0 plus, that is 5, that is come to 5. After that, 5 plus 5, that is 10, okay, 10. Then 10 plus 6, that is 16, it is 16. 16 plus 4, that is 20, that is 20. 20 plus 8, that is 28. So, finally, you got, that is 28. 10 plus 6, 16 plus 4, 20 plus 8, 28. So, time is 28. Total time is required 28, and this is the critical path. What is the critical path? That is B, B after that D, D after that H, H after that K, K after that 8, K after that N. Okay. For the class, no need to register and no need to do anything. Just you can subscribe to my channel and just try to join the Telegram group. If you want to join the class, no need to anything, no need to register, no need to do anything. just you can subscribe to the channel and try to join the Telegram group, Telegram channel. There I am sending the link and every day you can avail the class. Okay, nothing, no registration, nothing fees, nothing, it is all totally free. Got it? Is it clear to everyone? I am showing you the clean image. Try to see this, it will be clear to you. It is the clean image what I have taken, so try to see this. Now it will be clear to you. See this. Value add, that is what is the value we are adding. What is the value we are adding? See, here it was starting 0. Starting was 0. After that, the duration. What is the duration? Duration was 5 for the B. Here the critical path. What is the critical path? This is the critical path. This one. Then after that, this one. Then this one. Coming to here. After that, it is going to here. And finally, it is coming to here. This is the critical path. This is the critical path, right? The question will ask like that, ki they can provide you, they can give you in a, maybe they can give you a statement that these are the project, this is a project, and they can give you that chart, whatever chart, that is, I have shown you the chart, this chart, they can provide you the chart. From this activity, these are the activity and these are the duration and these are the dependency. Or maybe they are not providing the chart, they will tell that this is a project, there are different module A, B, C, D, E, F, dependency module, and D is dependent on D, can B can start his work after D completion, and F can start its work after A completion. And H can start its works after C and D. So, what is the critical path and what is the estimated time? What is the critical path? What is the estimated time? What is the project completion time? What is the earliest start? What is the latest start? In that way, they can ask. And what is the critical path? What is the critical path here? The critical path is 1, after that 3, after that 4, then 6, then 8 and 9. What is the critical path? So, that is starting from B, after that D, it is D. B, after that D, after that H, after that K and finally N, right? B, D, then H, then K, then N. This is the critical path. This is the critical path. What is critical path? Critical path means where it is starting and ending is exact. Here it is the delay. Here there are delay means here it is already end in 2, but here it is 8. Means it can be start at 8 also. Right. That is the maximum time. Where the maximum time is required. For which the maximum time is required. Maximum project ending time. What is the maximum ending time? That is 28 month. It will take maximum 28 month. Right? They can ask that in that way, ki what is the earliest starting time of what is the earliest starting time of K? What is the earliest starting time of K? That is 16. What is the latest they can ask like that is what is the latest completion time of that is F, G and H. What is the latest completion time of F, G and H? That is also 16. They can ask that is what is the earliest starting time of E? What is the earliest starting time of E? That is 2. What is the latest completion time of A? Latest completion time of A? That is 8. Got it? In that way, they can ask. They can form 5 question also. That's why I have told ki they can form 5 question also. Total set of question, that is nowadays they are asking in that way ki comprehension type question. So they can form a comprehension type question from software engineering also, because this is the related topic of software engineering. Okay, is it clear to everyone? Anyone have any doubt? Just try to think logically ki A, B, C, everyone started same time. Everyone started same time, but here it is ending at the time of 2, but here C, that is the dependency. A was dependent on A, E was dependent on A. Here we are merging the activity. So if you try to do in manually you cannot solve. So that's why we have to draw the chart. After drawing the chart only you can understand that what is the estimated, actually what is the time for the project, how much time it will take to complete the project, because manually you cannot draw, manually you cannot solve. If anyone asks that how much time, can you solve this, that from this table, if anyone asks you that what is the estimated duration? What is the estimated completion of this project? So, from this duration, can you solve it? You cannot solve. That's why from the precedence and where is the dependency, you have to draw the chart. After drawing the chart and after drawing the calculation in that way, you can only say that yes, it is required 28 month. It will require maximum 28 month because of the dependency. Otherwise, if you add these, that will be 2 plus 5, 7, 7 plus 4, that is 11, 11 plus 5, 16, 16 plus 7, that is 23 plus 7, that is 30, 30 plus 3, that is 33, 33 plus 3, that is 36, and it will be very lengthy. It will be very huge amount if you add all the duration, it will be a huge amount. But actually this huge amount is not required. Actually it is required 28 month. So that's why you have to do the project scheduling. You have to draw the part CPM, you have to draw the chart, that is part, right? Clear? Is it clear now? PART or CPM, the merge event represent. Answer everyone, answer. Yes, all of you are correct. Very good. All of you are correct. The completion just now we have done, and it is your concept is clear. See, and now your concept is clear. That's why easily you are solved. Easily all of you are able to solve. That is the completion. Right, easily you can have, easily you are giving the answer, that is the completion. So part and CPM, the merge event represent the completion of two or more events. All of you are correct, that is the completion. Right, now next one. This is also a previous year's question. I think this is the June or December NTA. It is also NTA question, June or December. This is also a previous year's question. Yes, Sarita, Poonam, Subhangi, Tamil, everyone is correct. So an activity chart, just now what we have done, that is also called activity chart. It is also called activity chart. An activity chart is a project schedule representation that present project plan as a directed graph. Just now we have drawn the directed graph. Directed graph means there is the arrow. Directed graph. The critical path is the longest sequence, is the longest sequence of dependent task, right? Dependent task, and its defined project duration, right? Just now what we have done? We have done the critical path, right? Critical path was the activity chart, and it was done the longest sequence, matlab maximum time. What is the maximum time for the project? That is the longest sequence of the dependent tasks, where the dependent task was there. That is the dependent task, and it defines the duration. So to attempt this type of question, your concept clear is very important. That's why I have taken this class. This two question was came only from the part and CPM in December 2019. That was four question, that was 4 marks. So they have asked the theoretical question last year. So anyhow, it is my assumption they can ask the practical question, that is the what we have done just now, they can ask this year. Okay, got it? Clear to everyone? Yes, that is the critical path. We have done just now the critical path. That is the critical path, longest duration. This is the longest duration, right, of the dependent task. Here, where is the, these are the dependent tasks, these are the interdependent tasks, all are dependent tasks. That's why the critical path is coming, because everyone is dependent. That's why we have to wait for the another. That's why we are calculating this, that are the dependent task, right? Yes. So take your breakfast and do your revision. Try to do the practice. Bye.